The world is a very religious place. While some of us are atheists, around 5% according to surveys, most believe that behind the stunning order of the universe stands some great mind, what many call God. It's an important question, one people feel very strongly about. After all, if there is a mind behind it all, our lives, we're told, are intended, part of a larger purpose. If there isn't, we are dust on the floor of eternity. Belief in a creator is very common. Just about every culture we know anything significant about has considered this an important idea. But is there any indication on the world stage that the God of our hunches has touched the earth in some observable way? Most religions claim some kind of revelation. Buddhism, for instance, rests on the profound insights of Siddhartha Gautama, the Indian prince who experienced a moment of enlightenment while meditating under a Bodhi tree. Hinduism looks to the Vedas, passed on to the first man at the dawn of time. And Islam says the angel Gabriel dictated to the prophet Muhammad the very words of God. Christianity claims something very different. At the heart of the world's largest faith is not just a profound insight or a mystical drama or even a dictation of divine words in a holy book, but a series of events which are said to have taken place in public, in datable time, and recorded by a variety of witnesses. For better or worse, Christian scripture is different from other holy books. In the events of Jesus' life, death and resurrection, believers claim to see a tangible sign directing us to the kingdom of God. Christians are therefore claiming to possess not just a dogma, a set of divine truths, but a verifiable history. As a result, the beliefs and texts of Christianity are suddenly open to public investigation. It's as if Christianity places its neck on the chopping block of academic scrutiny and invites anyone who wishes to come and take a swing. Which is why historians in universities all over the world feel at liberty to look at the Christian's holy book, called the New Testament, as a simple historical text. So what happens when the theologians hand the New Testament over to the historians? What do we find out about what really took place here in Palestine during the reigns of Augustus and Tiberius? In short, what can the historian confidently say about the life of Yeshua ben Yosef, Jesus, son of Joseph?